The Panel of Independence, created in 1960 through 1961 by Juan O'Gorman. This mural is held in El Museo Nacional de Historia in Castillo de Chapultepec, Mexico. Juan O'Gorman was a Mexican architect and muralist. He was introduced to drawing and composition through his father, Cecil Crawford O'Gorman, an Irish painter who settled in Mexico. Juan O'Gorman was a friend of a famous painter, Diego Rivera. O'Gorman focused heavily in architecture throughout his early life. In the mid-1930s, O'Gorman began to focus on paintings, typically creating historical and nationalistic narratives in both easel paintings and murals. The history behind this amazing artwork begins from 1492 to 1821. Spain sent explorers, conquerors, and settlers in search for wealth and land, land that they would then consider the New World. At this time, Spain was ruled by the Spanish King Charles V. King Charles V appointed a soldier named Hernán Cortés to discover the lands. Hernán Cortés first conquered the territory by overthrowing the Aztec capital of Tenochtitlan in 1521. Cortés built a capital city in Mexico City, which at the time was named New Spain. He became king of New Spain and gave criollos privileges that the rest of the indigenous and mestizos did not have. Criollos are people who were of Spanish descent but were born in New Spain. With this conquer came an oppressive religious government, a government ruled by the church. The church rule led to many deaths in New Spain. 300 years later, Father Manuel Hidalgo, a priest in the small city of Dolores, issues his famous call for Mexican independence. That call was known as El Grito de Dolores. It set off a revolutionary action by thousands of natives and mestizos who banded together to capture Guanajuato and other major cities west of Mexico City. Despite its initial success, the Hidalgo Rebellion loses steam and is defeated quickly. The priest is captured and killed in Chihuahua in 1811. Though the Mexican independence was not reached under his name, he started a fire which led people to keep pushing for independence, which is why he is recognized as the icon who freed natives and mestizos from Spain's oppression. Conservative Mexican leaders begin plans to end the viceregal system, a system ruled by royal officials, to separate their country from the motherland. In August of 1821, the last Spanish viceroy is forced to sign the Treaty of Cordoba, marking the official beginning of Mexican independence. Juan O'Gorman based his chromatic representational mural out of the efforts of the underrepresented population in Mexico and their fight for liberation during this time of the early 1800s. Here we see the gathering of the church members, a collective Spanish council that proposes the formulation of basic laws. In their hand are documents which are inferred to be documents that proceed in pushing their oppressive agenda against the mestizos. Their neutral facial expression signals that they are not part of the Mexican Revolution, in contrast to everyone else who is enraged. Their rich attire allows the viewer to further predict that they are part of the high church powers who aim to convert the mestizos into Christians. Because their goal was to convert the mestizos into Christians, the mestizos would be tortured and killed if they rejected Christianity. The torturing and killing can be seen through these four nude men on the bottom left. Their nudity symbolizes vulnerability, the vulnerability to the Spaniard powers. Two of them are in the position that points out their suffering and their discomfort. Another man is on his back, dead, as a woman weeps for him. Finally, the last naked man is crucified. His crucifixion is an allusion to Jesus, as he was also crucified in the Bible. In Christianity, Jesus was crucified because he loved his people and chose to give up his life to save the people of their sins so that they would be forgiven and have a chance to enter paradise. This, like Jesus, shows sacrifice of him and the men as they fight for their people, so that they one day too can reach their paradise, which is the independence away from the Spanish rule. Going back to the revolters, here we see Father Manuel Hidalgo, the focal point. He is the center of the mural and is wearing darker clothing. He is holding fire, which represents the rage in the oppressed people. The fire is also symbolical to power. The power of community unification is stronger than the royal few who oppress them. Then we see the mestizo surrounding him, ready to reown what was taken away from them. The direction of the mural goes from left to right. This allows the viewer to see that the protesters are moving right towards the lands they are trying to reown. Here we see the war flags, including the Mexican flag and La Virgen de Guadalupe. Hidalgo and Allende, captain of the Spanish army in Mexico who came to sympathize with the Mexican independence movement, marched their growing army through the towns of San Miguel and Celaya, where they killed all the Spaniards they could find. Like mentioned before, along the way they adopted La Virgen de Guadalupe as a symbol of protection. For in the Bible, La Virgen says, Oye y ten entendido, hijo mío, el más pequeño, que es nada lo que te asuste y aflige. No se turbe tu corazón. No temas esa ni ninguna otra enfermedad o injusticia. ¿Acaso no estoy aquí yo que soy tu madre? Which in English basically means not to be afraid, for she is our mother and will never leave us behind. Finally, we see the background of this image. It is shown and given traits of those to make the background seem farther behind the protesters. The background represents Guanajuato. Guanajuato is symbolical to the Mexican independence because Guanajuato was one of the first cities in Mexico to be won back by the revolters. This is my artwork, influenced by the sacrifice of the people for the Mexican independence. My artwork was created on a canvas. I used crayons, a blow dryer, tape, and gloss spray. The three-dimensional texture was created by blow drying crayons onto the canvas. The heat melted the crayon, revealing streams of red. Tape was used so as a hot crayon drips down, the tape covers the traced out figure in the center. There are distinct gradients of red, from light to dark. This light to dark gradient shows the fresh dripping blood of the Mexican revolters at the time of their fight. Then, the gradient goes to a darker shade of red. This is the same dripping blood of the revolters, but now, it is the old dried blood we carry on our backs. That serves as a symbolism to the people of Mexico, who carry on the history of their ancestors' fight for independence. Because of their ancestors' fight for independence, Mexico is now free from Spain's oppression. The man in the middle of my artwork is carrying a sword. The sword signals the weapon used to fight for their independence. The white color serves as the innocence and purity of the Mexicans or mestizos to the evil oppression of Spain. And finally, the gloss is used to contrast the dullness. Even though the fight was a tough and dull fight, they reached their independence. Therefore, I represented the picture with an untouchable shine of triumph.